We'll show you the most common solution out there. If I'm using this hammer here, we'll show you kind of how this works. Either drilling overhead, you're good. Drilling on the ground. Like I said, this goes in and out while you're drilling, but. So if you guys want, you can come check out the hole. That vacuum's got about a 7 second delay, something like that. It's gonna continue running after, so if there is a little dust there that's still falling out of the hole, if you're drilling overhead or right here, you can still vacuum it up with the end of that bit. But if anybody wants to try this one out, they're more than welcome. This is probably your most common unit that's gonna be used out there. So this will cover you up to almost an inch for your STS Plus applications. And then, did we bring the Max out? Can you grab the STS Max? Yeah. Same type of thing here. This is your universal attachment. You can see I turned it on here at the back. All your suction comes through the center of the unit here. That way if I need to put it on the front of my, you know, DeWalt hammer, my Bosch hammer, or anything like that, I'm covered. Same type of technology that's in that one. It's just it needs its own battery source, because if you are running it on a separate brand, obviously it's not gonna work off of that battery. So same deal here. That's only gonna engage when I physically push on the unit. So you see, if I pull off of it, it's gonna stop running, save you a little battery life and things like that. But same type of deal here. So you can see just about relatively no dust at all. If I'm gonna run this unit, you got it? Okay. So if I'm gonna run this unit without that, you guys can see just the amount of dust and the waste that's coming out of those holes off of just barely drilling two holes. And then you look at the two holes that we had a dust attachment, you can see kind of where your major difference is. Now, STS Max, that's where you're gonna have to jump up into your vacuum. And then, talking with the gentleman over here, you know, anything over 6 inches, you're gonna have to jump up into either a hollow bit or something like this shroud attachment, because we don't make any of the DE attachments that actually, you know, cover you that far. So if I turn this unit on, so you can see it suctions to whatever I'm doing. I run my bit through the center of it. You see there is maybe a little bit of residue there, but that's my shroud attachment. If I were to drill a hole without it, you can see the amount of dust that I put off and what's not collected. So it's just a general kind of overview of what you guys are gonna see, how we're compliant, the different mechanisms you can use for Milwaukee. All these cordless units are gonna be objective data. If you have any questions on that, it's on Milwaukee's website. We've done any possible testing you can think of, we've done it for you. So if OSHA ever questions you, you can say, hey, I got it, Milwaukee's done the testing, I'm squared away. Any of the vacuum attachments, you're good. If it's table one, you don't have to provide any sort of data like that, so.